Welcome to Web Style Brush. This is Slick Slider. Part of almost every website used in header banner, in testimonials, themes, projects, showcase, and much more. You can slide images or divs with it. Each div becomes a slide. It's a good slider, but because of its minimalist configuration, it does not provide content animation that is inside the slide. We are going to change that. In this video, we will enhance Slick Slider and add cool CSS animations inside each slide for the content of the slide. I have this HTML page and CSS. CSS is linked with it. Bootstrap and jQuery are linked with it. jQuery is dependency for the Slick Slider. We will link Slick Slider by using CDN links. cdnjs.com. Search for Slick, and here it is, Slick Carousel. You can get the links from here. It's a jQuery based slider. We will need CSS file and JavaScript file from Slick Slider plugin. In header, I will link Slick Slider's CSS files, Slick CSS, and then Slick Theme CSS, minified versions in the header. Then in the footer, we will link Slick.js file after jQuery. Slick min.js, minified version. And for the HTML part, this is our wrapper div with class name slider. This is a single slide inside it. This div will be a slide. It has got a div with class name inner. Inside it, we have got a heading and a paragraph. And then we have got an image. We will need more slides. This is slide 2. This is slide number 3. So we have got 3 slides. Slider will be initialized for this div with class name slider. I have images that I got from royalty-free images sites like Unsplash, Pixabay, and Pixels. Save, refresh. Okay, this is slider structure. Let's initialize slider. To initialize slider, after jQuery and Slick.js, we will use document.ready. Inside it, we will target our div with class name slider, slider.slick. And here inside it, we will have setting for the slider. Slider should repeat infinitely, slides to show one at a time, and slides to scroll one. Autoplay should be true. Autoplay speed, 5 seconds. This is 5 seconds. Dots false and arrows true. You can find all these settings here in the docs for Slick Slider. Let's see. Slider is working, but we will have to style the inner content. We want this content to be centered and over this image. Structure for our slide is, we've got slider, then div. Inside div, we have got inner, then heading and paragraph, and we have got image. Image is fine. This is the content we want to style. So inside slider, we have got div. Inside div, we have got inner. Inner has got heading and paragraph. Position for the div will be position relative. And div with class inner will have these styles. Position absolute, top and left 50%, transform, translate, minus 50% to make it centered, and text line center. Heading will have a background color, and it will have some padding, color, margin, line height, and display inline block. For paragraph, background color, padding, and font size. Save, refresh. each slide will move after 5 seconds automatically because autoplay is on. Okay, now slider looks much better. We want to add animations to inner content, this inner content. Slider is fine. Now this inner content, the title and the paragraph, we want to apply some animations to these two. In order to do that, we will need another JS library or jQuery plugin called Slick Animation and CSS animation library called Animate CSS. I will link this Animate CSS library in header. Before our CSS, this is Animate Min CSS, minified version for Animate CSS library. And I have downloaded Slick Animation JavaScript file to link with project. So I will link it in the footer before this Slick Sliders initialization. Slick Animation JavaScript file. Then we'll have to link Slick Animation with Slick Slider. So this is initialization for Slick Slider. At its end, we will have to add Slick Animation initializer for this library attached with Slick Slider's initialization. Now configuration is done. We will use Animate CSS classes to animate elements. For example, we want to animate a heading, this heading and this paragraph. First of all, for this heading, we'll have to add a class AnimateAnimated. Animate CSS library has changed. Before this change, this class name was different. Okay, now add custom attribute with value to define animation type and style. For this heading, we will use data animation in animate fade in down. This is class from Animate CSS library, and this attribute data animation in is from Slick Animation library. Data animation in, data delay in, data duration in. Animate fade in down is Animate CSS class that will animate element from above to its original location and change opacity 0 to 1 or 0 to 100%. Save. Let's look at the result. So as you can see, this animation is working for heading. Next slide. Back. This is working. Heading is being animated inside slide, right? Now you can add any other class from Animate CSS to change animation style. These are class names. You can click here to copy the style, animation style, and use in your project. Here, note one thing. This heading and paragraph are inside a div with class inner. This inner has got position absolute and then transform. While centering elements in a slide in CSS, I applied position absolute to a wrapper div, not the heading and the text that I want to animate. Do not position elements in slide that are to be animated. Apply outer div and position it to center or wherever you like it to be in slide. Use elements like heading and paragraph inside that and then animate these inner elements. Reason is Slick Animation or Animate CSS also transforms or position elements. If you will apply position or transform property to these headings and paragraph, original animation can get disturbed. So make sure you leave these elements alone that are going under actual animation. And get a wrapper or div outside these and position that div if you have to. Now we applied animation to a single element when slide comes into focus. There are other settings for this animation as well. you can define entering animation and time it takes to complete that animation. You can apply animation on exit and time it takes for element to exit with animation. There are more attributes for this animation, like I just showed you. Data animation end, fade in. This is old class for the Animate CSS library. Now these classes have changed, like we have used animate underscore underscore fade in down, and then animate underscore underscore animated. These classes have changed for Animate CSS. So the attributes are data animation in, data delay in, data duration in, and we have got data animation out, data delay out, and data duration out. So let's further enhance this animation. Data animation in, animate fade in down, and data delay in 0. Animation should start without delay. Then data animation out, animate fade out, save, refresh. Now you can see it is appearing and disappearing. It faded out immediately. So here we have to add data delay out, 3.5 seconds. Refresh. Now it stays and is disappearing just before slide changes. 3.5 seconds is chosen carefully, and it depends on our slick slider animation duration. See this autoplay speed, 5 seconds. Our slide stays for 5 seconds. So after a slide appears, its elements animate and then exit after 3.5 seconds. That is before next slide appears. So you'll have to take care about this autoplay speed and then this data delay out. Okay, so heading has got animation. Let's apply animation to paragraph as well. Paragraph class animate animated. For the animation, data animation in, animate fade in right, data delay in 0.2 seconds, and then data animation out, animate fade out, data delay out 3.5, same 3.5 seconds. Save, refresh. Now our heading and paragraph both are animating, and this will fade out just like that. Now animation for first slide is perfect. Let's apply animation to other elements in other two slides as well. This is second slide. First of all, let's apply animate animated here for this heading and this paragraph as well. Then for second slide, for heading, we will use animate fade in up and animation out fade out. And here for data animation in, we are using fade in up instead of fade in down. And then for the data animation out, we're using same fade out. For the paragraph, data animation in is fading up and data animation out is fade out. Animation time difference between these two elements is 0.2 seconds. Like here, 0.2 seconds. Similarly, for slide 3, for heading, we are using fade in down and data animation out fade out. And for the third paragraph, we are using fade in down. So here, heading and a paragraph, fade in down for data animation in and data animation out fade out. And for slide 2, heading and paragraph are using fade in up as data animation in, and for out fade out. For first slide, heading is using fade in down for data and animation in, and for data animation out, just fade out. For data animation out, we are just using fade out. You can choose any other animation from the Animate CSS library. Let's try this out. Refresh. This was first slide. And for second slide, animation is like this. And for third slide, animation will be like this. First slide, second, third. So elements are appearing from below, and here elements are appearing from above. So this looks pretty neat now. If you use arrows to move slides, animation will still work. So this is how you can enhance Slick Slider and add cool animations based on Animate CSS and this library. Slick animation. And we are talking about animating inner elements for slides in Slider. You are free to use any animation from Animate CSS library and apply it to any element. Elements can be heading, paragraph, buttons, image, div, or anything. Okay, I hope this video helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.